local owner of an electronics store says he's been victimized for the second time in months. Burglars are targeting his store despite his repeated efforts to boost security. WESH's Dave McDaniel is there live right now with video of the latest break-in and the owner's frustration with what he's seeing from police. Dave.
Well, that's right, Martha. You know, this business owner has done a lot. He put pillars up in front of his store when somebody tried to drive through the front of it. He has bars on the window. He has security gates. He has security cameras everywhere. But still, thieves keep coming. The cameras catch the suspects in the act, and the owner hopes somebody recognizes them as they grab luggage off his shelves, stuffing that luggage with expensive inventory.
They pulled the luggage and stuffed it with knife and cameras.
Taken in the break-in, cameras, laptops, cell phones.
Picked up the expensive items, not the cheap items.
It happened around 5 in the morning Wednesday. One suspect tried to jump a counter, didn't make it, breaking that glass as well.
I have two security systems, one wireless cell phone, so if they cut the wires, so I would have a backup system.
The owner says with the cameras, gates, and bars, he's doing all he can to not be a victim. He says he needs more help from OPD.
They have one police officer working overnight. There's no such thing as visibility. We have plenty of visibility during the day while they're getting revenue from giving tickets for speeders around the corner. We watch them.
The Orlando Police Department says it has officers all over after dark.
We have several officers in all sectors of the city, including International Drive.
The owner also has an issue with response time, saying the laws forced the alarm company to call the store before the police.
Monitoring station has to call the store first, or the premises. After, they have to make two different attempts or contact before they call the police department. That's about 6 minutes. All it took for the thieves, 5 minutes.
Orlando police says its ordinance follows state law. And
once the alarm company notifies us, we are dispatched immediately and respond.
And again, OPD says it will work with this frustrated business owner, as will it work with other business owners up and down the I-Drive area, not just so that they feel better protected, so that they are getting the best protection possible. Reporting live along I-Drive in Orange County, Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.